One is 0.03 milligram per kg, the second is 0.67 milligram per kg, third is based on IGF titration. So this is there. Now, most of the height, this is a study which is, you know, done in North Europe, small aggression study, where they found that the titration, IGF titration dose is not, is very not very effective. And the titration resulted in physiological IGF changes with a wide range of growth hormone dose. So poor growth. So if you use a dose of 35 micron, you see the high TID is best here. IGF titration, it is not that good. Before, if you use with higher dose, you get a better. So first year, second year, first year, you can see the results are better with the dose as such than doing IGF titration. Maybe it can be more helpful for, you know, as a marker for the response. So when do you, then next question comes, how long should I give it? Should I give it 2 years, should I give it 4 years, should, when it reaches a centile, should I stop at that time? So therefore, there were a lot of studies. The study following children below 4 years of age, till 4 years were given growth hormone in SGA, they found that 41% of these patients, they needed a second course of growth hormone treatment due to a decrease in height to below 2 SGA after some time. Then there was another study, they said 5 year discontinued growth hormone treatment in a group of SGA children who had increased the height initially after 3 year growth led to significant decrease in reduction height by 1 SGA. So there were some study which showed like this. So therefore it was decided that it is better to continue growth hormone to maintain the gain in height SGA than to discontinue after you have reached the centile. Let's come to safety. So now you have the age, you have the dose, you have the, you know, when to discontinue, the age. Safety and monitoring conditions with regard to growth hormone is similar to that for other conditions, whether it is for growth hormone deficiency, internal or not. The treatment in short children born SGA is safe and well tolerated. There are no indication that growth hormone in this leads to increase in mortality or more side effects. So there may be some exceptions. You know, there are a lot of SGAs who may have chromosome instability. Certain syndromes are there, because therefore you may be careful in using growth hormone in those patients. So what are the other beneficial effects of growth hormone besides these SGA babies? You know, we know SGA babies are more prone to have metabolic syndrome, they're more prone to have premature adrenarche and other things. So it normalizes in effect the body mass index, the lipid profile, improving the blood pressure, psychosocial profile, bone mineral density, without advancing bone maturation, changing body position, and or inducing precocious onset puberty and hyperglycemia. So there are a lot of studies with JCM, they all published studies, they're showing that, you know, this is another marker to improve beside the growth in these SGA babies. So just to summarize quickly, 10% of these children born SGA have poor childhood growth, so resulting in short stature, which we just showed there. Either a dose of 0.03 milligram or 0.67 milligram per kg per day normalizes child growth result, resulting in adult height within the normal population. Only thing is that these children have to be monitored carefully. And children who do not catch a postnatal growth have to be, you know, monitored carefully, and then they have to be given this thing. So evidence suggests that growth hormone is safe and well tolerated, as I showed you in the studies. So therefore, to conclude, optimizing dose to attain the best earlier treatment is associated with improved response. Higher the dose, faster response toward the target height. IGF-1 based titration is less effective. Maybe it is more of a use for, you know, following it up as side effect or, you know, prevent complication. And continuous growth hormone admission better than discontinuous. Just stop it, and then when she reaches height, centile, and then you continue again, and then you continue again like that. You know? So, thank you very much for your kind attention. I try to maintain a time range since morning I'm listening.
Thank you, IPS, for making it interesting and finishing in time. I think we have got time for a couple of questions from the floor.
Yeah.
Sir, which dose, I mean, you have mentioned two doses, and, you know, cost will be just double, 0.033 and 0.67. So, and you said the higher is the dose, faster is the response. But better my question is, what
better,
is the...
Better the response.
No, you say faster is okay. So is there significant difference in the final height if we are treating with the lower dose and with the high dose? What is the difference in the final height? So we take 1 year longer. Okay. That's okay.
So there you come to prediction models. You know, many of these prediction models have shown, because it's the first year prediction model. So what they have found that, you know, when you use a higher dose in SGA babies, even this iGrow model is showing SGA, Turner's and this thing. So they found that when you use a higher dose, you get a better response, but the first year response. This is not been followed up next year to the final height, but this is there. If you use a 0.603 versus a 0.037, the better response or prediction is better with a higher dose as compared to a smaller
but
dose.
But the final height, they must have, I mean...
I think it remains the same, you know. That you have to esteem, but they have not mentioned anything, that studies.
I think there are studies which mention the difference in the height achieved over a period of 6 years. And there is now data available that suggests higher dose will actually improve your final height as well. But the difference in the height, the dose is exactly double, 37 microgram versus 67 microgram. The improvement in the final height in terms of centimeters is probably 1 centimeter per year of therapy attained with the higher dose.
Okay. Thank you.
Any other questions or comments?
Yes, something. See, I'll tell you one thing. And in this iGrow prediction model, what they have done is they started higher dose. So once the patient reaches a certain height, you know, and they're following a path, then they switch on to the lower dose. And they keep on doing the IGF-1 values for complication, not for titration of this thing, because they found that IGF-1 is not a very good for starting dose and seeing what's happening with the patient. So they are doing that so in order to maintain that the complications do not occur. So there are studies which are showing that when you do a prediction model, the response is good, you start getting it, then you can decrease the dose and see what's happening. But as Dr. Bhavan mentioned that, you know, every year you get a little extra growth if you give it a higher dose as compared to this thing.
Thank you. Just before